Hello everyone. So in today's session of Thoughtful Leaders, we have Dr. Pranjali Kulkarni, who is the head of the Department of Civil Branch from Dhole Patil College of Engineering. I heartily welcome on our College Dunia platform, which is the India's largest reviews platform. Welcome, ma'am, and thank you for sharing your time for us for the interview session. Sir, ma'am, with your permission, should we start with the questions?
Yes, of course.
Okay. So my first question is, what is the latest program that you are offering in your institute which will help students outperform and stand apart from the crowd?
So latest program what we have offered in our institute was civil engineering only. Manish, can I interrupt in between Raj? So
okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the programs which we offer, the various programs are there, but the recently which we had was on-site training. So we have seen students are learning many things in the classroom. They are also going for the site visits, no doubt. But a special program we have started for the students in which whatever they learn in the laboratory or whatever they learn in the classroom, the same thing they will be implemented on the site. It was around, say, some 30 days program was there in which whatever theoretical aspect was there of civil engineering, all they have seen on the site. So they were given a huge exposure to industry. See what actually is going on in the industry, because the need of industry is changing continuously. So this program had helped them a lot. They have, the number of employment has been increased and students are now confident to what they are learning and how they are going to implement those things in their future projects.
Okay, ma'am, moving on to the next question. What are the factors that make this course the best to students to opt?
Okay, so if you see, it is a civil engineering course. It is one of the oldest branch of engineering and it has a very great history of the great civil engineer, starting from Dr. Vishveshwarya, who has been called the father of engineering. And being the oldest and the core branch, civil engineering has always a bright future. There are n number of career options which are available in civil engineering. And the most important part which we will see nowadays, many years ago when I was in the college, only very few girls were there for civil engineering. So if you say in my batch, only I was there. But now if you see in our classes, 50% class is of the girl students. So that is one of the best part which we see, because now the girls has understood what are more career opportunities available in civil engineering. Not only on the side job, there are a very huge opportunity available in civil services. Many software courses are there. The students can do that software courses and grab a great jobs they want. And even after civil engineering, they can change their fields. As it is an interdisciplinary branch, they can change their field and they can move to some another, maybe the IT industries also. So this is the best part what this branch offers. So, and it is a core branch. So whatever there in your daily life, it is all where you need a civil engineer. So I think this is the best what I feel from this branch.
Okay. What will you say the best practices in the course you are offering?
Okay. So the best practice what we offer, what we have, the main objective of Dhole Patil College of Engineering has always been the quality education. And in line with this, all the branches are always doing the efforts to give the best quality to the students. Now, the best practices, if we see, there are many best practices, because every time we are finding what better we can do and what best we can come out of. So if you see the best practices, as I said, there are many. But one I would like to highlight, recently, 2-3 years back, we had one very good initiative under AICT that is called as Internship Day. Under this Internship Day, we have the students who are going to the internship, and in this pandemic situation, the students have undertaken the online internships also. so which have helped them to gain the stipends also and exposure to the industry. So this internship, if you will see, this is a great opportunity provided by AICT, and we are very fortunate that we are one of the institute who have been taking this internshala day as an our activity, in which around 1,000 students from Dolli Patel College of Engineering and from Civil Engineering Department have participated in various activities, various internships which are available throughout the country, and they have done excellent. And I'm very fortunate. I'm very happy to announce that this year we are on the 35th position at All India rank. So this is one of the best practice which we have adopted for the students. And internship, that is nothing but the actual exposure what you are going to do in the industry. So doing the internship, say for 1 month, 3 months, this have always benefited for the students, and we are very happy this time. So that's why our placement count has also increased, and the students are becoming employable. That is more important. So that I feel it is one of the best practice we have done this year.
Okay, and that's a great insight about Dolli Patel College of Engineering, and this initiative can fulfill many of the students' dream as well. Am I moving on to the
students? And the students are doing it so interestingly, and many of them are the college partners also. So they come to the students and they tell them ki go for the internship, it is very important, do those internships, and definitely they get a small amount of stipend. So it is sort of encouragement for them to do more internships, and it is helpful for them. So it's a great
Definitely, ma'am. Ma'am, moving on to the next question. How does the program ensures that the students are being prepared for the future?
Okay. See, apart from the curriculum, so curriculum, it is not in our hand, as we have affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University. The curriculum has been updated, say, after 3 years, 5 years, and the changes are made. But what the industry need is continuously changing. And in civil engineering, we have n number of materials coming in market regularly. The usage of that material, the different techniques the civil engineers are using, the softwares which we are using. So it is continuously updated. So for this purpose, we have MOUs with various industry, with various companies, with various organizations. With the help of these organizations, we understand what is the need of the market or what is the market scenario. And depending on that, we try to train our students, or we try to give more exposure to our students. And as I said, the civil engineering has a number of opportunities. So it may be software or it may be a civil service course. So I'm very happy to share with you, in our college, we have a special civil service cell where the students are being given the preparation for the competitive exams, maybe for the GATE or maybe any other civil service exam. So more civil engineering students are interested in such type of exam. So they are being given the training. And the first generation, the chance of being the first generation entrepreneurs are very, very high in civil engineering department. The student can start their own startups. And I think it is the very best than being placed anywhere. So they can start their own startup, they can have their own ideas. So this is what we make the students to prepare. So we have entrepreneur development cell. Under that, we have different activities. We tell the students, or we train the students, we have workshops for the students to how to become the first generation entrepreneurs. Apart from this, n number of activities are going in the department. It may be projects, it may be the projects which are related to the campus. So one more thing I would like to add, the students of civil engineering department, they have made a project for a complete campus. So how to make the campus eco-friendly? They have done the complete rainwater harvesting of the Dolli Patel College of Engineering campus. They have done the waste management study, and they have given the solution for the waste management. So as the problems are there, so the problem statements for the projects are available nearby. The students are undertaking those daily day-to-day projects which are there in our lives, and they can find the solution. So for this, we train for the student. So regular curriculum, it is there, no doubt. But apart from this, we have such type of hands-on trainings for the students to make them more employable.
Okay, ma'am, moving on to the next question. How did you train yourself and your faculty members to deliver this program to the students?
Very good question. Actually, for the teachers, they should be updated, and then only we can tell the students. So definitely, the faculties are undertaking different types of trainings. So it may be under any regulatory authority. So it may be under the AICT or any other regulatory body. So regular trainings are being given to the faculty. The faculties are undertaking the courses. Also, we have the online courses. So online courses which are available for the faculties as well as students. But the faculties are also undertaking those courses. What are those courses? They are nothing but what are the recent trends in engineering or recent trends in civil engineering. Apart from this, they are attending different types of seminars, workshops, which are there regularly, which are happening. Even we are also organizing. Our college has also organized many seminars, workshops, short-term training programs for the faculty development. So regularly, we are making sure that faculties are being updated. They are connected with the industries. That's why we have all those MOUs, so that faculties should be connected with the industry. And what is going in the industry, they should tell the students and they should train the students accordingly.
Okay, ma'am, moving on to the next question. How do you tend to build an industry connect with this program?
Industry connect. As I said, Manish, actually, we have MOUs with various industries. So in civil engineering, we have around 18 MOUs we have. So with this industry, what we do, so MOU, when we have this MOU, so these are with the different types of, it is also with the software training companies, it is also with the construction companies, it is there with the cement industry, it is there with the scaffolding industry, it is there with the green building industry. So like this, we have different MOUs with the different types of companies which are there. So when we interact with them, and fortunately they have many programs, the students participate in those programs, so they understand what is going on in the market, and then we deal with the issues. So like this, we have the connect with them, with the industry. And the same, many of them, when they see the students, they see the performance of the students in the internship, the companies are coming for the recruitment. So the students are more comfortable where they have done the internships, there only they go for the jobs. So that is one of the connect what we have. And nowadays it is a necessity. You should be connected with the industry. And definitely we are focused on that.
Okay. Ma'am, what were the challenges that you have faced while implementing these programs in your curriculum?
Actually, challenges, what I would say, so we have taken those challenges as the opportunity, I would say. So the challenges may be with the resource person, or the challenges may be with the students coming to the courses. And as I say, girl students coming to these courses. So these were some challenges which we have undertaken, but definitely we have the great counselors in our college who counsels the students and who makes the students understand what is the importance of this. And definitely we have overcome those challenges and the students are doing these programs very well.
Okay. Ma'am, what are the different types of projects that the students are working on through this program?
Students, as I've said, n number of projects have been going on in the college. The students are very much interested in preparing the models. So I would suggest you to come to our college and see the models. They have fantastic models they have prepared. So it may be the scene showing how should be a green city, or how should be an eco-friendly city should be there. So the model they have prepared. So that is one of the very interesting model I find. Then second is they have shown the eco-friendly campus. So how self-energy generating campus they have prepared. So that is one of the best, I can say. These are some models they have prepared. Apart from this, they are taking the projects, and we have always emphasized the students not to take the hypothetical projects. They should go to the society. They should understand what are the problems which are there in the society, and they should undertake those projects. So the students are using the technique. They are even using the computer techniques like C programming, C language, and other fuzzy logics to solve these issues. They are also using some different techniques from civil engineering to solve this problem. So these are the various projects which students are undertaking. The students have made the project where the campus can be eco-friendly, the complete rainwater harvesting of the campus, waste management of the campus. The students have also participated in various competitions, project competitions, and they have grabbed the awards for that. So when we say the projects, so the project is, I think it is the, what we can say, it is the heart of your engineering. So the students are identified of what, on what projects they are doing. So the projects are very important for the students, and we always emphasize the students to get the good projects. Now in this pandemic situation also, it has become very tough for civil engineers because most of their projects are on field. So they have to come, but they have found the different problem statements on which they can work at home, say from with the help of computer modeling. They can find the solution, they can collect the data, and they have done the fantastic, some projects are really fantastic. So like this, we help them to find the great projects, and like this, the quality of projects is maintained.
Okay, moving on to the last question of the day, ma'am. What message do you want to give to the current youth and the aspiring students who are looking to pursue a career in civil engineering?
Civil engineering, I would say, is a great branch, and we at Dolle Patel College of Engineering is offering that course from last 7 years. All the three branches, all the three batches which are there till now have came out with the flying colors. Not only our college, but civil engineering is a branch where you have to work on ground. So the laboratories, the state of art laboratories we have. So actually what we need is how the students are working in the laboratory. The students who are finding their career or thinking to have the civil engineering as their branch of engineering, definitely I will tell them there are n number of opportunities available for you. You are choosing one of the best branch of engineering. Definitely you can go for that, and you should be very focused, you should be very hardworking, you should have that mindset of taking the failures also. You should have that, and you are always welcome at Dolle Patel College of Engineering.
Okay, that's all for the day, ma'am. Thank you for sharing your time with us for the interview session, and it was a wonderful session, and I myself have gained many insights about Dolle Patel College of Engineering, and I hope that the students who will be viewing this video in future will get ample amount of information about Dolle Patel College of Engineering, specifically the civil branch. Thank you for joining us, Ms. Arman. Have a great day.